Hi guys, CodeTutor here and my name is Anil Deshpande.
In the discussion so far, we have only seen the implementation of the app 1 where we implemented the content provider. Now, our focus will shift towards the second app, app 2, which will be actually consuming this content provider. Now, how do we get started here? For that, we have to basically create a content resolver instance in the app 2 and then use the matching content URI as arguments. Here you can have a glance at the content URIs that we have created in app 1. Now, after that, you will use the content resolver's method like query, insert, delete, update, which will be invoking the corresponding content provider's method. Content resolver in app 2 would be having corresponding same methods. You will observe later during the demo phase that even the arguments of the content resolver's query insert delete method match with the content provider's query insert delete update method. And that is how the content resolver and content provider communicate with one another. So let us have a quick glance at the code to understand how this app gets implemented. So in the code, I have created another application to do client. The to do client will be actually accessing the content provider that has been defined in the DB to do list application. And you can see there are two activities here, main activity and second activity. And then I have created interface. This interface basically defines the URIs. These are the URIs that have been defined, which actually corresponds to the URIs that we had created in the content provider. And then we have created constants for the columns that we would be interested in querying from the database. I will quickly show you how the application is supposed to work. This is our application which contains the content provider. Here we are doing all the operations using the database. We are not using the content provider here. But this is not the application that we are talking about. We are talking about another application called as ToDoClient, which is this particular application. So let me launch this. You can observe that the UI is different and values we are fetching is actually from other application. This application is using the content provider concept to fetch the values from the other application. You can see here that we are getting the count here and we are just displaying all the values from that particular content provider. If I want to do a querying based on place, say desk here, and then get for place, it will only query from a particular place. Next, it will go to the another activity. You can do a insert functionality here. I will create a sample to do and places from desk and I can add it. And you can see that it got added to the to do client first activity. And if you go back to the first application, you will observe that it also got added here because ultimately it is actually getting added to the same database. Now we will go back to the other application. If you want to update, you can update that. So the ID is 8 here. Go next. I want to change the to do item whose ID value is 8. Let me make it call was for dinner and modify. And now you can see that it got updated to a new value. If you want to delete it, you can just enter 8 here and say delete, and that value has gone. And if you just want to cross check, can go here and that value is not available here anymore. So I will go through how the code has been implemented. So here I want to get total count. So that is why you will observe that if you go to set count, I am using content URI 3. It returns me some cursor and I fetch the overall values and display it here. Now coming back, set all to do's. Set all to do is being used to set this data. So once again, I am using content URI 1. I get the cursor, just iterate over the cursor, set view with the whatever the values that I have. Then coming to the get for place. For that, I have another method called as set specific place to do's. As you can see here, I am getting value that user enters here. That value I am passing as argument to the query method and I am using content URI 2 and it returns me a cursor. Then I just do the same thing, which is iterating over the cursor and then setting the UI. This is how, by passing different URIs, I am managing which particular data set I want to get from the content provider. And when I go to the next, I have another activity here, that is second activity. And in the second activity, I have an insert functionality. There is a add to do method. If you observe, it fetches the to do string and the place, which are two views where the user will be entering values, pass on those into the content values, and then pass that content values to the insert method. And if you observe, the method signature of content resolver's insert method looks pretty similar to a content provider's insert method. And in the same way, to do update functionality, I have an update to do here. It once again uses the content values and passes arguments as a content provider would expect it to be. So it would be a URI, the content values, the new values that you want to update, and then the where clause. Where clause would be column to do ID equals to question mark, and question mark would be replaced with whatever the ID the user has entered in the edit text. And then comes the final delete functionality. There is a delete to do here, and as you can expect, I am passing a where clause with question mark to do ID, and this will invoke content provider's delete method. With this, we have completed the discussion of implementing custom content provider, and in the next video, I shall come with a new topic. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.